Hello and welcome to another episode of What's Inside. Today we're looking at a World of Warcraft Molten Core raid deck. This is obviously another raid deck. This is a special edition game extension. And like the other raid decks, it's you're fighting a big monster. This one's a lava guy. Let's get right into it and see what we got. I believe this was the second raid deck to come out. Cellophane speed up. The box is a little banged up from the age, I think, mostly storage, but it's brand new, so everything inside should be good and secure. As usual, you get the cool upper deck box. These boxes are pretty well designed, they're pretty sturdy, so whatever cosmetic damage happens on here, probably not going to affect here unless it's crushed. So the art's pretty cool as always. Say what you will about Warcraft, they do have some pretty sweet art. Alright, so we got a little advertisement here. Art card set from the Alliance. And on the back there's just some picture of that chick. Alright, there's our big cards. We got our rule book. Let's see if I can get out without tearing it up. Alright. So, this one is "By Fire Be Purged" is the motto. This is the official rule book. This is just a thin little thing. Start phase, new boss phase, minion phase, etc. So it's in color as always, and it's pretty decent quality. This one's a little cheaper than some of the other ones, I think, but not a lot. Not enough for me to complain about. Pretty nice overall. Good color, good theme to it. It's interesting to have like a fire theme enemy. So let's look at our decks here. There's our treasure pack. We're gonna do that last. So, alright, we got four little packs here we gotta open, and our big cards. Let's start with our big cards, because those are the easiest, and they're huge. Alright. So, we got Lucifron, which is foiled, as you can see here. Ooh, shiny. And then on the back, here's a special ability, or technically, I guess, this is probably the front. This is a Hero Flamewalker, Boss 1. Lucifron has plus 2 attack while attacking and can attack only heroes at the start of your third turn. Flip him. On the back, he says, Lucifron has plus 2 attack while attacking and can only attack heroes. At the end of the turn, Lucifron deals 6 shadow damage to each opposing hero. So it's pretty brutal. Then we've got, doing them in the wrong order here. Magmadar. So, he's got 12 health. So, and then we've got Gehenus. He's only got 11, but still pretty tough. We've got Gar, 14. All these guys are pretty nasty, and they're pretty tough. So, they're not just going to deal you damage, they can take a lot more than it looks like, too. Just because they have low numbers doesn't mean they're not going to kick your butt. And we got Baron Geddon. The names are a little cheesy on some of them. Shazra. Then Sulfron Harbinger. Then we've got Golmag the Incinerator. And Majordomo Executus. And lastly, Ragnaros. Alright, so let's look at one of the decks now. Alright, the first deck we're going to look at is this one here. This is, I think, is our Minions deck. No, maybe not. I don't know. It's this deck. We're going to look at this deck. Okay, we're gonna look at that one. I apologize for the edit cut there. I had to adjust the focus a little bit. So this is our first deck. And here we have, let's start at the back. So we've got a Ancient Core Hound ally, Chrome Hound minion. We've got another one, another Core Hound, Fire Lord. When Fire Lord enters play, put a lava spawn into play. There's another Fire Lord, another Fire Lord, a Flame Imp. A Flame Imp, pretty minor guy, but still can do some damage. Another Flame Imp, another Flame Imp, another one. There's lots of Flame Imps. Oh, there's another one. There's another one. Oh, we have a Lava Annihilator. When Lava Annihilator enters play, you may destroy one target ally. It's not bad. Another one. Another one. Another Lava Annihilator. Here we have a Lava Pack. When Lava Pack enters play, put the top card of the minion deck into play as an ally. That's pretty nice. Another Lava Pack. Another Lava Pack. Lava Surger. When Lava Surger deals combat damage to a hero, ready Lava Surger. It can't attack that hero this turn. Another Lava Surger. Another Lava Surger. Another one. Molten Destroyer. When Molten Destroyer has plus one attack. Oh, I'm sorry. Molten Destroyer has plus one attack and plus one health for each rune you have. Another Molten Destroyer. Molten Giants. Molten Giants. Molten Giants. Oh, here we've got some tokens, it looks like. Son of Flame ally token elemental. And on the back is a Fire Sworn. So we've got 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those tokens. Then we've got some more here. We've got a Flamewalker Priest ally token. And on the back, we have a Flamewalker. Pay 1, destroy Flamewalker, destroy target equipment. That's pretty handy. 1, 2 of those. And here we have a Core Rager. It's a protector. At the end of your turn, ready him. It's pretty cool. And on the other side, we've got a Flamewalker Elite Protector. We've got 2 of those. And here we have a Lava Spawn. At the start of your turn, put a Lava Spawn into play. So they kind of reproduce themselves. And on the back, we have a Flamewalker Elite Protector. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of those tokens. And then our last two are Flamewalker Priest. Tap him. Flamewalker Priest heals 4 damage from target hero or ally. Use only on your turn. And on the other side, we have a Flamewalker Protector. Exhaust target ready ally. That ally deals melee damage equal to its attack to its controller hero. Use only on your turn when you tap it. So, not bad. Alright, so let's get this stack out of the way. Then we'll go to this deck with the red border. See what we got in here. Alright, here we've got By Fire Be Purged. It's an ability, choose 2, destroy all opposing abilities, destroy all opposing allies, or destroy all opposing equipment. So you get to destroy all of one thing. It's pretty good. There's another one. Die Insect, ongoing. When opposing ally is destroyed, draw a card. When an opposing hero is destroyed, draw a card for each rune you have. So there's 2 of those. We got an Elemental Fire. Another Elemental Fire. Flames of Sulfuron. Ragnaros deals 1 fire damage to target hero or ally for each rune you have. Another flames. Flaming Assault, ready Ragnaros. That could be deadly. Another one of those. Fury of the Fire Lord. Ooh, that's a cost of 15. It's an ability. Ragnaros deals 50 fire damage to each opposing hero and ally. This damage can't be prevented. Fury of the Fire Lord can't be interrupted. That's probably a game ender then. Hammer of Ragnaros. It's just a destroy target ability or ally or equipment. Another one. Lava Splash. Another Lava Splash. Magna Blast. Or Magma Blast, I should say. There's a second one. Melt Weapon. Destroy all of target opponent's equipment. That's a jerk card. There's another one. Now for you, Insects. Interrupt target ability, ally, or equipment card. Another one. Unstoppable Flame. This turn, Ragnarok has plus X attack, is untargetable, and can't be protected against. It's two of those. And then we have Wrath of Ragnaros. Destroy target ally. Ragnaros deals fire damage equal to that of the ally costs to a hero in that ally's party. So there's two of those. And that's all the red deck, which appear to be all be abilities, of course. So let's get those out of the way. Now, let's open this deck. Ooh, that one's got a different back. Fancy. Alright, these look like they might all be resource cards, maybe? Oh, these are runes and some ability cards. So, let's see what we got here. We've got a Rune of Cress. At the end of the turn, roll dice, and each one does something different. One, nothing happens. Two or three, Magmadar deals 1 fire damage to each hero and ally in a party of your choice. 4 to 5, Magmadar deals 3 fire damage to an opposing hero or ally. 6, each opponent puts an ally from his party into its owner's hands. And then Rune of Mohan, opposing heroes and allies can't be healed. That's kind of rude. A Rune of Blaz, at the end of your turn, destroy all opposing allies. Rune of Zeth. Rune of Mazj. Rune of Koro. Rune of Theri. So these must be the rune cards they're talking about, obviously. I haven't played this in a really long time. I don't even remember. I think I only played this like once, maybe. So, alright, so then we've got the regular cards again. So let's get these out of the way. Move them over to the other pile here. We've got Ashes to Ashes. Another one. A third one. Flame Burst. Each opponent destroys one of his resources. Another Flame Burst. Another Flame Burst. Flames of the Incinerator. Flames of the Incinerator. A third Flames of the Incinerator. Gehenna's Shadow Bolt. We have two of those. Three of those. Hotter Than Goo. Destroy all of target opponent's abilities, allies, and equipment. Another Hotter Than Goo. A third one. Inspire. You may flip your hero. If your hero is Sulfuron, Harbinger, you may ready him. A second one. A third one. Lava Pool. Destroy target ability, ally, or equipment. Another Lava Pool. Another Lava Pool. Lava Spit. Lava Spit. Lava Spit. Living Bomb. Attached to target opposing ally. Ongoing at the start of your turn, destroy a attached ally. If your hero is Baron Geddon, that ally deals fire damage equal to its cost to each other hero and ally in its party. That's pretty cool. Another one. Third Living Bomb. That's pretty cool. Lucifron's Curse, choose one, destroy target ability or interrupt target ability card. If your hero is Lucifron, you may choose both. A second Lucifron's Curse, third one. Magma Shackles, attached to target hero, attached to target ally and exhaust it. Ongoing, attached to ally can't ready during its controller's ready step. While your hero is Gar, each ally in that ally's party can't ready during its controller's ready step. It's pretty rough. Another Magma Shackles. A third one. Shazra's Arcane Explosion. Got two of that. Three of that. Tight Quarters. Destroy target equipment. There's a lot of destroy equipments in these. Two, three of that one. Unexpected Distraction. Prevent all damage that would be dealt to target hero or ally this turn. Two, three of that. And we have Volcanic Lair. Ongoing at the start of your turn, if you have five or more resources, destroy target opposing hero. And we have three of that one. So that's all the cards except for our treasure pack. Let's see what kind of cool treasure cards we got. Now remember, these are probably foils if they stick to what the other sets are. And if you've been watching this channel for any length of time, I love foils. So this is probably the best part of it for me. So this is what it looks like sealed. We're going to ruin that. So if you have one of these sealed, I'm about to make yours worth slightly more money. Alright, let's see what we got here. Foils. Ooh, I love foils. Rokidar, Longbow of the Ancient Keepers. When you strike with Rokdilar, your hero has long range this combat. So, pretty foily. Next we have Shard of the Flame. When a resource enters play under your control, your hero heals 2 damage from itself. Now there's 30 of these foils. Obviously we don't have 30 cards here, so there are other ones out there. This is just what I've got in this set. So these are random. Everything else is fixed. But these are the random ones. Don't expect to get these exact cards, as usual. Leg Plates of 10 Storms. Then we've got a Perdition's Blade. When Perdition's Blade enters play, your hero deals 1 fire damage to target hero or ally. Pretty weak weapon though. It only costs 2, does 2, 1 resource. I'm sorry, 2 resource. Yeah, whatever. You know what I mean. Obsidian Edged Blades. 1, discard Obsidian Edged Blade from your hand. And then put 1 plus attack counter on target 2-handed sword. Does 4. Shadow Strike. Destroy Shadow Strike if your hero has Enchanting, draw 2 cards. Leg Plates of Wrath. When you play a sword ability, you may pay 1 if you do ready target armor. Band of Sulphurous. Spinal Reaper. Ooh, that's got a cool name. Looks like it's for warriors and paladins. When your hero deals fatal combat damage with Spinal Reaper, draw a card. Pretty cool. Judgment Leg Plates for paladins. When you play a paladin ability, you may pay 1. If you do, prevent all damage that would be dealt to and dealt by target friendly ally this turn. Alright, so that's what's in our treasure pack. All in all, not a bad pull, I think. There's some good cards here. But these cards usually are good. So, that's what's inside the Molten Core deck. Give you a pretty good idea of what you get in the packaging and an example of what you could pull in the treasure deck. So that's probably going to do it for this episode. We've seen what's inside the Molten Core raid deck, and I don't know what else to add because the show's all about seeing what's inside the packaging. So that'll do it for this episode. Thanks as always for watching, and we hope to see you next time on What's Inside.